Hello everyone, it's DK24 here, and today I will be teaching you guys how to tack up a horse. English style, so I'm here with Onyx, and I already groomed him and brushed him, so we're going to tack him, and I'm going to show you how. So let's get started, because I do have a riding lesson to go to. So, first off, I'm going to get my saddle pad. I gotta do this with one hand, so it's going to be difficult. Alright, so you're gonna throw your saddle pad up. You're gonna put it just up in about the middle, or I sometimes go a little further because my saddle will slip down, but you're gonna probably put it in the middle of the withers, like so. So now you're gonna get our half pad, same thing, just lay it right over top of the saddle pad itself. Up here. So you're gonna put your saddle up here like this, and you're gonna only leave a little air here so it gets in there in the withers. Don't worry about stirrups, they just kind of do this sometimes. But that's a trick to fold them up like that so they're not like banging on him while you're walking him. You want these to be right underneath here. The outside. Leaning, so we're gonna push it over here. Some. Okay. Like that, so same thing. Sorry, stirrups. Okay. This is like the most awkward video I've ever made. I just thought I'd take advantage of it because there's no one out here right now. Oh my gosh, these stirrups are really. Okay, you know what? Never mind. But again, same thing. Make sure that the girth thingies are right here, down underneath his elbow. And so now we're gonna get the girth. So I'm not using martingales, so I don't use them with him. So you're just going to, of course, slip them through here. Okay. So you're just gonna slide that through the first hole. Right on there like that, and ignore this strap here. I'm not even sure why it's there, and you're gonna do the same thing on the other side. So put this here, and then put it on the first hole, just like that. Just checking what time it is so I'm not late in my lesson. We got plenty of time. Okay, so now you're just gonna get it as tight as you possibly can on this side. Hopefully this is his girth anyway, because it's kind of loose it looks like, but you're just gonna do the same thing over here and get it as tight as you possibly can. Okay, so just like that. It's pretty simple. Just make sure the girth is here and not like way back here or something. You want it to be underneath our elbow. So yeah, you're a good boy. Putting up with me talking to absolutely nobody. Okay, so now I'm going to put my helmet and stuff on. And I'm going to try to set my camera somewhere where you can see me put his bridle on. So, go ahead and unclip your cross ties or lead rope or whatever you're using to tie him up. And put the reins over his or her head so he does not run away, or at least you can do that with my horse, because he, as you can see, he's backing up right now because he likes to try to run away. Straighten up your bridle, and then go ahead and take the halter off. Throw it over your arm so it's not in the way. Hopefully you guys can still see. I think he kind of like moved out of the way. Now he's a really good boy, and he'll open his mouth for me, so I don't have to struggle to fit in his mouth. But, it's all twisted. The problem. He says he can come to me. Here, bud. I got it straight this time, so you don't have to deal with that in your mouth. There we go. Okay, so just slide it over his ears. Most of the time, horses will refuse the bit, and you're gonna have to like try to stick your hand in their mouth. So they will open their mouth because. Where the bit is, they have my teeth, so you can really, you be able to fit one finger into the nose band at least, or two, same about a dog collar. So I'd say about two fingers in the nose bands. And in the throat latch, you should be able to put your hand in there entirely. So, yeah, as you can see, I'm going to put my entire hand in there. Just slip the thingies in. And you're ready to go. So this was not a very detailed video, but hope you guys enjoyed.